today we are celebrating success. I think a whole page was read about me, how I did well in life. But before it all happened, there were a lot many failures. So I'll talk about failures. We normally don't talk about failures. We celebrate success, we talk about success, we reward success, but we don't reward failures. To my mind, it is absolutely imperative to understand the importance of a failure. Because whether we admit it or not, all of us have failed once, twice, many times in our lives. People who succeed are the ones who manage to manage failure. And that is what I want to talk about to begin with. And then, of course, I'll talk about happiness as well. But why do I talk about failures? Because your capacity, your capability, your ability to handle your failures will ultimately determine your success. I am reminded of my school days. When I started schooling, in the first few years of my tenure as a student, I didn't win a single prize. I used to participate in all the races, all the competitions, but I'd never won a prize till class 7. And I was gradually getting very frustrated because each one of us wants to win a prize, no? Each one of you wants to win a prize, wants to do well in life, and when you don't do well, you start feeling frustrated. But then I came across a book which explained to me, or tried to explain to me, which I understood much later, that my friend, try and enjoy the journey. Try and enjoy the moments that you are in. Try and improve the present. Your future will be made. Focus on your present. Do what you can do well, but don't so much bother about the results. I, at that point in time, had not read Gita. But later on, this message came very clearly in Gita, which clearly says, Karmanyavadikaraste ma phalechu kadachana. Meaning, focus on your journey. Focus on your karma. Don't bother about the results. If you can get into that mental makeup, success or failure will not stop you from becoming even more successful. You become indifferent to rewards. The moment you become indifferent to rewards, you start focusing on the present. And the moment you start focusing on the present, you will see a dramatic improvement in yourself. I saw that in my life. So after class 7, when I won my first cup and my first medal, there was no looking back. Probably I won anything or everything that an individual would want to win in a school, in a college, in a service. But even as I was winning, there were failures. It's not that your life is not continuously successful. Those that may have done well, extremely well in class 12, those who would have qualified in NEET examination, it is not necessary that they would succeed thereafter. Because it's a continuous struggle to continue to do well. And that is what the challenge is. How do you meet that challenge? Again, by the same principle. Focus on the present. You know, the past is gone. The future is not in your control. The present is. And if you do you well in present, then it's certain that future will be built. Future is born out of the present. Sometimes we spend a lot of time in brooding over what has happened in the past. Why did I do this? Why did that person do that to me? Why did this go wrong? No. How much time do you spend in your past? You do spend a lot of time in your past thinking that friend who is my friend did not speak to me well yesterday. He hit me yesterday. You know, you are continuously obsessed with the past. If you can somehow get out of that past, now it's not very easy, but you have to make an attempt. If you get out of that past, then the chances are you will be able to focus on the present. And if you focus on the present, you can be certain that the future will be built. Now, how do you do that? I have told you what you should do. As Chairman Saab said, it is not merely what do you do, it is how do you do? How do you go about doing what you have to do? First is to understand what you have to do. And there your teachers, your guides will be able to tell you what needs to be done. Then how do you do it? I'll give you a simple example. We all should be drinking a lot of water during the day. I don't know whether your teachers have told you, you should be drinking about 10 glasses of water a day. But if you just know that, it won't happen. You have to make it happen. How do you make it happen? You put an alarm every hour to have a glass of water. Do that for 21 days. Every hour there will be a small alarm. You drink a glass of water. On 22nd day, you will not require the alarm. Automatically, your body would have tuned that you'll start feeling thirsty after 1 hour. I have given you a very simple and small example. This can happen to anything. Even it can happen to your thought process. If you start thinking positively, you have to make a conscious effort. Because initially, you like negative things. You like, some of us like violence. Some of like speed. So we have our own likes and dislikes. To get over that, you have to constantly fight against yourself to see how you get over that. You can't do that. You have to practice it over a period of time. And as a student, you've been doing that. When you start learning a new thing, you keep doing it over and over again. And then it becomes your second nature. That's what you got to do. So my suggestion to all of you young friends is, never give up, never give in. Keep trying, irrespective of the results. Results are not in your control. The present is in your control. Your own activities are under your control. Your own attitude is under your control. Your own behavior is under your control. Don't bother too much about others. Now, this is the second point, which is related to the first one. We are so obsessed with what others are doing that we forget what we should do. So when it is my problem, I somehow find a reason that it is somebody else's problem. So we waste a lot of time in thinking about issues and persons over whom we do not have any control. Now, Bhubaneswar does not have that much traffic problem, but I used to get very irritated when I used to get stuck in a traffic jam. Very irritated. Why is it so? And I used to get so angry that if someone came before me, I would hit him. I used to get very agitated because I used to feel, why is the car moving? Now, that traffic is not under my control. It's there. So my wife is sitting here. She used to tell me, and I have internalized it over a period of time, bhai tum kya kar loge? Iska kuch kar sakte ho? Jab kuch kar nahi sakte to kyun pareshan ho? Aram se music suno, baith ke gab karo, kitab padho. Ye traffic to jab hoga tab apne aap hoga. My suggestion, second suggestion to you is, there will be not lot of events in your life over which you have no control. I have seen people fighting with each other because Dhoni played a wrong shot and India lost the match. No? Arey, ye shot agar usne nahi khela hota to India jeet jati. Uspe maar peet ho jati hai. Aap log kai baar kitni baar ladte hain on issues over which you have no control. Lekin ladte hain kyunki aap kehte hain arey ye acha hai, wo kehta hai wo kharab hai. Aur lad gaye. America ne Iraq pe attack kyun kiya? Ispe kai logon ne hatapai ho gayi. Na to America pe aapka control hai, na Iraq pe koi control, lekin aap lad lete hain. Aap sochiye apne jeevan mein. Go back to your days and try and discover how many times you got angry over issues over which you have no control whatsoever. You waste your energy. Do you get what I am saying? Are you with me? You appreciate what I am saying? Have there been issues when you got angry over issues over which you didn't have any control whatsoever? Yes or no? So will you think over it and see not to lose your cool over issues over which you have no control. Because that will give you a lot of time and space to improve yourself. This brings me to the third point. That ultimately, it is you who that matters. It is I that matters. It is how well you improve yourself that matters. Don't try and change the world. Change yourself. And charity in any case has to begin at home. You should try and become something which you want the world to be. Mahatma had very clearly said, Mahatma Gandhi had said, be the change you wish the world to be. Before trying to change the world, in any case, you should not try to change the world. Change yourself. And this brings me to the fourth point. There is no such thing as objective reality. Apne aap mein koi cheez achhi ya kharab nahi hoti. It is my subjective thinking that makes me make it good or bad. Again, I go back to this World Cup that is happening these days. Football matches between one country and the other country. No, fortunately, unfortunately, India is not playing there. Had India been playing there, it would have been different. But even then I see that if I am favoring Brazil and if Brazil loses, I feel very bad. And if Germany wins, I am opposed to Germany, I feel very bad. Now, this good or bad is determined by my predilections, my understanding. In itself, one country has won, other has lost. There is no thing good, bad, happy, unhappy. It has happened. It's an event that has taken place. It is my subjective understanding, my own understanding, that determines whether one thing is good or bad. So I thought I should share this with you. And finally, I don't want to go on and on. I mean, you all must be sweating sitting there. I have an AC running right behind me, so I can go on and on. But the last thing that I want to discuss was something which Chairman Saab said about happiness. Happiness is purely subjective. It is not determined by the objective events around you. It is how you perceive objective reality, how you see things. You go out on a street, you will find a vendor who's selling vegetables smiling in this heat. But you and I go there in that heat, we'll sweat and after some time curse and run to some place where it is cooler. So happiness is determined within, not without. So if you want to be happy, you have to be happy. No one else can make you happy or unhappy. Under no set of circumstances should you get unhappy or happy on account of someone else trying to make you unhappy or happy. You have to condition yourself so that you enjoy the moments. And I come back to the first point that I made. Ultimately, it is the present that matters. Enjoy the moments that you are in. Chairman Saab said that I have taken the trouble of coming to Bhubaneswar. Let me tell you, I have enjoyed every moment of my existence in Bhubaneswar, and I love talking to you. That's why I'm here. I wouldn't have come here if I had not enjoyed the moments that I had yesterday, and I'm enjoying the moments here. So I enjoy moments that come to me. There are few things over which I have no control, but yet I try and enjoy those moments. So I believe happiness is internal to me. No one else can make me unhappy or happy. I can make myself happy or unhappy. It's a choice, as he rightly said. You have the choice. You have to make that choice. And before I conclude, I'd like to narrate a few lines which I narrated yesterday, but children were not there. I think they are more relevant to the children. It's in chaste Hindi. All of you understand Hindi? Good, Bollywood. It's because of the Bollywood. You watch movies, all of you? But the language that I'm going to speak will be a bit terse. Now, why I'm saying what I'm saying? You must be wondering, after the lady read about the good things that I've done in life, the achievements that I've had in life, they have not been failures. I have met with failures, as I said in the beginning. And there have been moments when I felt extremely frustrated. I come from the state of UP, where the political scenario was extremely bad. And as civil servants, we were under enormous pressure to do wrong things. And it was at that point in time, the poet in me got out and I composed these lines. And I asked the Almighty, the God, I questioned him. Sanshay nahi man mein, sanshay is doubt. Sanshay nahi man mein, teri srishti mein ya tujh mein. Tu hi tu mere man mein samaya, sab kuch maine tujhse hai paya. Phir bhi stabd hoon, vyakul hoon, ashant hoon, shayad anjaan hoon. Kya yahi jeevan hai? जो पापी है दुराचारी है क्यों जीत रहा निरंतर है स्पष्ट करो अभिव्यक्त करो कुछ तो करो मेरे राम. दिस वॉज माई वेदना. आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू क्वेश्चन द लॉर्ड, वाई इज द रॉन्ग मैन विनिंग. आई डोंट नो, सम ऑफ यू हैव हैड दैट एक्सपीरियंस बिफोर, दैट वॉट इज गॉन रॉन्ग विद द वर्ल्ड, वाई आर द बैड पीपल विनिंग. बट इफ यू आर एन ऑप्टिमिस्ट, if you are a die hard optimist, the response will come to you immediately, as it did in my case. And it came to me in this manner. Samay ruka nahi, samay ruka nahi, hum kyon thehar gaye, abhi to hum chale bhi nahi, phir kyon thak gaye. Utho pathik, pathik is a traveler. Utho pathik, mad bhramit ho, dhumil andhyare mein, shresht vahi jo ghira nahi ho, shanik nirasha mein. जागो जगाओ मन मत बहलाओ एक मसीहा तुम भी बन जाओ. जय हिंद.